even though you already did it, we're gonna repeat them. Okay, so hello, how are you?
I'm fine.
How was your trip to Connecticut?
Great.
How was it?
It was great.
You did a what?
Yeah.
Win. What kind of competition was it?
Was the competition, how do you say, prototype?
For prototypes or what kind? Products?
Yes, but technologies or softwares and things.
Yeah. You did something about food, right?
Yeah.
Nutritional project. It was creating something that was supposed to be nutritional.
Yeah.
Okay. And who was also speaking classes? What did you do last week?
Last week?
Yeah.
Thursday.
Thursday?
I have a lot of homework.
Oh, okay. And did you finish all your homework?
Yes.
So you won't have more homework for the
week?
All right. Okay, so let's start this. I'm gonna show you some pictures. I want you to look at them. Let's see. Now, you will see three pictures. We're gonna go one by one. I want you to tell me who are these people that I'm going to show you. I want you to explain me anything that you know about them. Let's wait a little bit for the projector. Oh, there's nothing there. Can you see anything?
Yes.
Yeah, a little bit, but yeah. Okay, who are they? Let's see the first one. Do you know this person?
Yes.
Okay, who is she?
And
what can you tell me about her?
She is a singer.
Okay.
She's an actress.
All right, what else?
She's American.
All right, anything else?
She's a trainer.
Okay, what else can you tell me about her?
She has blue eyes.
All right, what else?
She's crazy.
Sometimes. What else? What about when she was a kid? When she was younger.
She was an actress.
Where?
Montana.
All right. Was she looking or did she look the same?
No.
All right. I need. Okay. Sit down. Your turn. I want you to help me writing only two sentences of what they said already about Miley Cyrus. In this cardboard that we have here, can you repeat me again who is this person? Know the name. I know that it's Miley Cyrus. Who is Miley Cyrus?
She's a singer.
Okay, can you write it? Something else?
She's an actor too.
Actress. All right. And that's it. Only two. We're gonna write only two to have. Okay. Who's the next one? Okay. What can you tell me about Orlando Bloom?
He's an actor.
Okay. Another actor. What else?
He's British.
Yeah. British?
Yes.
Okay. What else?
He participated. Caribbean.
Pirates of Korea. What else?
And the Lord of Rings and
No? Alright. What else? That's it? Can you tell me anything else about what I don't know? Alright. Another volunteer? Volunteer. Okay, just two sentences. Again, what was, can you tell me one of the sentences?
She's
he.
British. He's British. He's a... British.
Okay, only two. That's enough. Thank you. Okay, and the last one.
He's old.
He's
old.
No.
But he was old.
He's old.
Okay.
He was
old.
He died. Last year.
He passed away.
In the past 2000.
Yes. 3 years ago.
Three years ago.
Okay, what else?
In an accident.
What kind of accident?
A car accident.
Okay, what else can you tell me about him?
He participated
in
an
accident. That's it. Alright. Victim.
On
okay, again, two sentences. Can you help me with the first one?
Yes.
She already told you what. As
he was.
Okay.
He is.
Okay. Well, actually, he was. In the picture, he is, but he was.
He was.
He isn't anymore.
He is.
No, he isn't.
He was.
He was.
Yes.
Okay, what else? You never trust your partners what they said. Then you need to confirm.
They're fighting.
She's always fighting.
Yes. It's part of the class. Ready?
No.
Alright, thank you. Now, let's check these three sentences, or these three groups of description for these three people. Can you help me in try to connect the first two sentences? How can you describe this by using one sentence?
She is a singer and an actress.
All right. But what about this one?
He's a musician.
And this one?
Well, usually he was a handsome actor who participated in the film.
All right. Now, what she uses right now, can you repeat the last, your sentence? Loud, so everybody can hear you.
He was a handsome actor who participated in the film.
Okay, do you know exactly what is that? That you use for joining the sentence? Yeah, who? You said he was a handsome actor who participated in Fast and Furious. What is who? A linking word? No, linking word. It works as a connector, but it's not exactly a connector. Okay, it is a word that sometimes we use as for a question, but in this case, we are using it for connecting two ideas or two sentences that are providing us extra information. That's what we are going to see right now. Okay, let me turn this off. You don't need it. Have you seen this before in the previous models? Probably yes, but you don't remember. Because Luz was able to use it Maybe because we read in the book. Maybe you have used it in another activity or read it in an exam or in a text, and you use it without knowing exactly how to do it. But I remember correctly last class when we were talking about giving opinion, some of you use relative clauses when you were expressing or giving information about the dolphins. Now, we are going to see the different relative clauses that we have, but we're going to work only with three of them. Now, we're going to have personal, object, and possessive clauses. These are the three that we have right just now. We are the possessive, we're not using that. Possessive is not difficult to understand since it's a clause that is showing or that we use when there are two sentences or one of the sentences that is the dependent clause. We are talking about, we are using possessive now. Right now, let's focus on this one. I'm gonna give you an example. What thing? So like Nelly. Let's use Nelly's thing. Let's make one sentence. We are waiting for Nelly. Nelly goes to CELEX. I have two sentences just right here. We are waiting for Nelly and Nelly going to CELEX. Right? These are just two sentences. What we are going to do now is to connect these two sentences, which one of them, which is the second one, is going to provide us extra information about Nelly. What can I do, or how can I use this, or how can I connect this with the relative clause that you just used for that example?
We have what?
We use who?
We are waiting for Nelly who goes to CELEX.
Okay, so what did you do?
Change name.
Okay, you just modify or omit the noun Nelly and use who, right? Otherwise, we are repeating the word or the noun twice. So this, using the relative clause, is going to help us to avoid repetition. What do I have in that example? She is a singer. She is an actress. How can I do that using the relative clause? Is who was it? Miley Cyrus? Okay. How can I use those two with a relative clause? Miley Cyrus?
He's a singer. Who? He's an actress too.
Alright. And the second one?
Orlando Bloom. Yes. Orlando Bloom. He's an actor. Who is it? He's British.
Orange. Who is British? Now, in this example that he gave us, he connects both sentences for providing more information about the person using the relative clause who. Now, we have two more. The other one is which. When do you use which? When do you use it? As a question.
When you have different options and you can choose one, and you maybe ask which one.
Okay. So if in the first one, who, we're talking about people. In the second one, which is which, we're going to talk about objects or things, because we can select, but in this case it's not a question word, So that's the reason it's not only about options. If we were using wish as a question word, it's because we're selecting from different options. But right now, we're using wish as a relative clause that is going to substitute an object, a thing, yes? Animals, probably. But who is only for people? But, there is another one. That is another relative clause that we can use with which, or instead of which, or instead of who. You can say, Miley Cyrus is a singer that is also an actress. Yeah, you can use who or that. All right. Now, there are more information about relative clauses. It's depending on the use, depending on the kind of or the function that you are substituting the noun. It can be as a subject, or it can be, as a personal noun or subject, or it can be as an object. Right now, we're not going to go into the details because first I want you to learn to identify when we're using who and when to use which. Later, we're going to go into the details. Now, do you know what is this, right? What is it? A what? No, that's a Spanish. How do you call that in English? Start with D.
No.
No? Die. A die. Now, we're going to roll the die, because I only have one. We're going to roll the die twice. Why? The die has six numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What I want to show you on the screen is gonna be six columns with six sentences or six words. In the other side, another column with another six words. What you're going to do is to roll the dice. The number that appears on the face of the dice is the number of the word that you're going to look at the projection. You don't have it yet, but you will look at it at the projection. Once you check the word, ding, you are going to find the connecting word in the other column. And you are going to link, or you're going to join both sentences by using the relative clause which, who, or that, depending on the subject that we're using. Yes? Yes, so we're gonna roll it once, not two, sorry, because the other ones we're gonna take more time. Just roll the dice once, check the number, look for the number on the screen. Once you've located the number and the word, look for the partner or the matching sentence in the other column and make a complete sentence using relative clause. All right? So, how many times are we going to roll the dice?
Only one.
And what is going to show us the number? What do we need to know, or why do we need to know the number? What is the number for?
First, the word.
For the words. How many columns are we having in the screen?
Two.
All right. So this number indicates column one or two?
One.
Only column one. Are you sure?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So you were paying attention. Ready? Who wants to be my first one with you?
In order.
In order?
Oh, no, there is something.
Hey, Tom, what's happening?
Yeah.
Is it because Nelly wants to participate and you don't let her speak?
Yes.
Okay, Nelly, ready? Okay, roll the dice. On the floor, on the table, whatever you want.
The table?
Number?
One.
This is he. What is a kid? Help.
Now, relative clause, remember, is not only a linking word.
The last class we were working with linking words in for addition or for giving contrast, etc. This is not a linking word only to connect them, but it's a word that helps us to provide extra information about a previous sentence that we had. Yes, that's the objective of these classes. Now, I want you to check this. This is only a practice activity. In this handout that I'm going to give you, you have 10 sentences. 10 sentences where you are going to have two different sentences. One is providing extra information for the previous one, but it's missing the class that you're going to use to connect them. So what you're going to do is to select which of the three words that we saw is the correct one and put it in there and connect it. So you have to rewrite it on the line. All right?
Yes.
So what are the words that we're going to use?
Who will you use that?
And when do you use that?
In both with people or
objects. Does everybody have any word that you don't understand, just ask.
Yeah.